student book. Get your science student book. Open it. Open it to page 59. Page 59 is before 60, right? Page 59, there is a picture of a sunflower there.
Living and growing.
That's right, living and growing.
Is the what?
Page 59. Is everyone here? Everyone ready?
Yeah.
Okay, before we are going to continue with our topic, let's have a review first. Can you remember what was the last topic that we had last meeting? Anyone? Can you remember? Who remembers what was the last topic that we talked about?
Materials.
Very good. We talk about different kinds of materials and how you group them. We also talk about metals and non-metal, right? Can you still remember it? Metal and non-metal. You remember? Yes or no? Metal, non-metal? Okay, tell me. Tell me. I'll give you an example and then tell me if it's metal or non-metal. Steel. Steel. Metal or non-metal? Steel. 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 Metal. How about gold? Gold.
Metal.
Metal. How about clay? Clay. Metal or non-metal?
Non-metal.
Non-metal. Very good. How about silver? Silver. Metal or non-metal? Silver.
Metal.
Very good. We also talk about materials. How do we save our environment? What do we do for the different kind of materials? What do we do? We recycle. We also what? Reuse and recycle in order to do our part in saving our environment. We don't keep on throwing garbage or litter everywhere. We should learn how to reuse and to recycle, especially with plastic, because plastic doesn't decompose. They don't disappear. They remain on our earth for a very, very long time. So if you keep on throwing plastic, it will just what? It will just accumulate until it becomes a lot. And then our earth will be full of plastic. It will be very dirty. Okay? So you have to do your part by reusing and recycling. Any more questions about the last topic? Yes or no? No more questions? Did you understand the last topic? Hello? Yes, Miss Bethany?
Yes, Miss Bethany.
Okay, you have to answer me. Okay? Okay, now, are you on page 59 already? Did you find the page?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, what do you see on page 59? What kind of flower is that?
Sunflower.
A sunflower. What is the sunflower doing?
Rising in the sun.
Growing.
Facing the
sun.
Okay, facing the sun. Do you know that a sunflower moves?
How?
Even though it is a plant, it moves. How? How does it move? It follows, it faces the sun. So for example, in the morning, where does the sun rises from? From the east, right? So when the sun is from the east, sunflower head faces the east. And then it follows the sun. It follows until noontime. It's there up at the sky. It follows it. It faces until it goes down to the west. The sunflower still follows it. That's how the sunflower moves. But it doesn't move like us. It doesn't move like human beings or like animals. It doesn't walk. It doesn't jump. It doesn't, what else? Doesn't hop or crawl, no. The sunflower head just follows the sun, the direction of the sun, meaning it just faces the sun. The word for that one, when some plants do that, when they follow the sun, the kind of movement, it's a difficult word, yeah, I will show you, but don't mind it. It's a difficult word. It's called heliotropism. Okay, follow after me. Heliotropism.
Heliotropism.
Yes, it's a difficult word, but that's the word when the plant follows the direction of the sun. That's what the sunflower is doing. It moves, but it doesn't move like human beings. It doesn't move like us, but it still moves. Do you know why? Because sunflowers are living things. So that is our new topic. Our new topic will be about living and non-living things. Okay, before I'm going to start, I want everybody to sit down. Some of you are still standing up. Sit down first. Sit. Sit properly like you are in the classroom. Sit properly.
The flowers are a little scary. They can move by itself with the sun.
They move, but they just faces the sun. They don't walk. They don't run. They don't jump. No, they just face the sun, the direction of the sun. It's not scary. It's amazing. It's interesting, right? That some living things do that. Okay, ready now? Everybody sitting properly? Let me see. Okay. Okay, let's continue, yeah? Why do the sunflower do that? Because they are they are living things. So our new topic will be about living and non-living things. Okay? So now turn your book into page 60. Page 60. We're going to talk about living and non-living things.
Okay. Are the butterflies can walk or fly, right?
That's right. They fly. They walk.
Fly.
They have legs, right? They crawl. Insects crawl. Okay. So let's read this one. What are living and non-living things? Okay. I'll ask. Let me see. Kaylin. Kaylin, can you read this paragraph here? What are living and non-living things? Ready, Kaylin? 1, 2, 3, go.
What are living and non-living things?
Okay, we can.
Can divide the word into living and non-living things.
Plants,
animals, and humans are
examples
of living things. They are alive.
Very good, Kaylin. So what are living and non-living things? We can divide the world into living and non-living things, meaning you can group the things in the world, the creatures in the world, into living and non-living things. So what are examples of living things? Answer me, what are examples of living things? What are the given examples? Kaylin just read it. What is it? Plants? Come on, guys. Answer me. Plants? What else?
Plants, animals, humans.
Animals, humans. Humans. Very good. So we have plants. This one, the flower. Animals, including the insects. And humans. Okay? Why are they called living things?
They are
it's in here. They are what?
Alive.
Why are they called living things? They are
alive.
So people or human beings, animals, and plants are living things because they are alive. Are you a living thing or an unliving thing?
A living thing.
A living thing because you are alive. How about your book? Is your book a living thing or a living thing?
No.
Say the word. Say the word.
No.
Non-living
thing.
Why?
Thing.
Why?
Not alive.
It's not alive. Very good. Yes.
Please,
okay, Sharapova.
Please.
Yes.
What should I do?
Page 60, Domenico. Ready? Ready? Okay. Sharapova.
And what do I do with page 60? Yes.
Listen to me while I discuss, okay? Okay, Sharapova, can you read this one?
These are examples of non-living things. They are not alive.
Alive. Okay, they are not alive. What are the examples of non-living things?
Books.
Toy.
Rock.
Very good, Sharapova. So these are examples of non-living things. Why are they non-living things? Because they are not alive. Like what? Like books, a toy, and a rock. How about you? Show me a non-living thing near you. Show it to me now. Hold something that is non-living thing. Me.
Caesar. I want to be.
Yes, you may, Jonathan. Okay, let me see. Are you holding a non-living thing? Okay, very good. That is a non-living thing because it's not alive. So again, we can divide all creatures and things in the world into two groups. We can divide them into living things or non-living things.
I want to pee.
Yes, you may. Again, living things, non-living things. Okay, living things are things that are alive, and non-living things are things that are not alive, okay? So let's talk about the characteristics of living things. How would you know that it is a living thing? Turn to page 61. Page 61. Are you on page 61?
Yeah.
Okay, page 61. Jillian, can you read this one? What are the characteristics of living things? Ready, Jillian?
the characteristics of living things.
A goldfish.
Look at
the things around you. How do you group what you see as living and non-living? How do you know that something is alive or is never alive?
Living things?
Living things breathe.
Okay, very good, Jillian. That is one characteristic of a living thing. How do you know that it is alive? What is the characteristic? It?
Because they breathe.
It breathes. How about you? Do you breathe? Do you breathe? When you say breathe, you take in air. Do you take in air? What do you use to take in air? You use your nose like this.
It's in the ocean, you can't breathe in like this, like a human.
Yeah, underwater you cannot breathe, but sea creatures can breathe underwater, but they don't use their nose. They have gills. They have gills. The fishes, look at the picture. The fish also breathes underwater, but they can breathe underwater because they don't have a nose. They have gills. Gills work differently with our nose. That's why we cannot breathe underwater because we have a nose, not a gill. Do you understand? You use your nose to breathe. So when you hold your nose like this, and you close your mouth, can you breathe? No, you cannot breathe if you hold your nose and you close your mouth. You can't breathe. And what happens if you will not breathe?
You will die
because living things need air in order to stay alive. That is how you know if something is alive or not. You will know because that thing breathes. Okay? One characteristic of a living thing, it breathes. Do you understand? What is one characteristic of a living thing? How do you know if it is alive? It? Okay, number one, breathes. Again, what is one characteristic if it is a living thing? It breathes. Okay, remember that one. That is one characteristic of a living thing. It breathes. So, humans breathe. We take in oxygen. We need that one in order to stay alive. Plants also need oxygen. They also breathe. So if you put a plant inside a box without air, it will die. Animals also breathe. Land animals have noses, right? Like the dog, because it breathes. It breathes in order to stay alive. But how about this water bottle? Does this water bottle has a nose?
No.
The water bottle does not breathe. That's why it is not a living thing. It is a non-living thing. This is not alive. How about your book? Does your book have a nose?
No.
Because it is not alive. It doesn't need to breathe. It doesn't need to breathe. Because it is a non-living thing. Again, all living things need air in order to stay alive. Like this fish, like this human, and this plant. I'll show you what a fish girl is, looks like. If you're asking how fishes breathe underwater, right? So this is what fish gills looks like. That's what they use in order to breathe underwater. So you don't have a gill, right? That's why you cannot breathe underwater. You need oxygen tank if you want to breathe underwater.
Imagining that you have a gill.
You just imagine if you have a gill. It's not possible. You cannot breathe underwater. Okay, again, I will repeat. One characteristic of a living thing is that it... Hello? Look at me. You're not paying attention anymore. What one characteristic of a living thing is? It?
Breathe.
Very good. Okay, number two. Another characteristic of a living thing. How do you know if it is alive? Page 62. Tell me. Page 62.
It grows.
It grows. Very good. Number two. Living things grow. Okay, Hansel, can you read this one? Living things grow. Ready? One, two, three, go.
Living things grow.
Hansel. Darren, Hansel.
Living things grow. The size of living things change over time.
Okay, very good. The sizes of living things changes over time. Look at this human. Look at this human being. From a baby, and then it grows into a boy, and then into a teen, and then into an adult. Okay, how about this animal? A cat. From a kitten, then a young kitten, a young cat, and then an adult cat. And then the plant, from seed, then a small plant, a young plant, then into an adult plant. What happens when living things grow? What happens? What happens with the person, with the cat, and with the plant? What happens? They become?
They get bigger.
Bigger and?
Taller.
Taller. They become bigger and taller. Why are you all so busy there? Can you get a baby picture? If you have a baby picture there, get a baby picture and show me your baby picture. I will also look if I can find a baby picture of myself. You have a baby picture? If you don't have a baby picture, it's okay.
Yes. I have in my baby picture.
Okay, show me baby picture.
I have one in my phone.
But if you don't have, it's fine. If you have, you can show it to me right now. Oh, Agnes! That's so cute. Is that you when you were a baby? How about Hansel? Oh, Hansel doesn't have hair. You're so cute, Hansel.
Miss.
Yeah?
Miss, I'll get my iPad. The baby picture is in my iPad.
All right. Who's that? That is Missy Kaylin? Oh, Kaylin. Is that you in the middle? So cute. Oh, look at Kaylin. You look so cute, Kaylin, in the middle one. No, you don't have baby picture. But it's my picture when I was a toddler. Okay, this is me. When I was young. See? That's my sister. This is me. And I'm still small.
I have a baby picture, but it's in my iPad.
Yeah, it's okay, Stan. Only if you can show it to me. Who else wants to show their baby picture? Oh, Louise! Louise, so cute! Who else wants to show their baby picture? Okay, so look at your baby picture. Did you stay the same? Do you still look the same as your baby picture?
No.
Look at me with my baby picture. Do I look the same with this one? No, right? No. You don't stay the same. You grow bigger and you grow taller. That's what happens to living things. Living things doesn't stay the same. They become bigger. They become taller because they grow. All living things grow. And let me see, Jonathan. Jonathan, do you have baby picture? So cute, Jonathan. You're very cute. Is that you when you were a baby? Oh, you're very cute. Who else wants to show their baby picture? Did you stay the same? Are you still that small baby? No, right? You grow bigger and you grow taller. So that's one characteristic of a living thing. All living things grow. Plants human beings, and also animals. We don't stay the same. That's why we are alive. We are living things. Okay, ready? Others are gone. Where is Hailey? Where is Hailey? Hailey? How about this notebook? Does this notebook get bigger and taller?
No.
Does the notebook get bigger and taller?
No.
Because the notebook doesn't grow. Yeah? Yes?
I have a baby hamster.
You have a baby hamster. Where is it? Still small. So if you take good care of it, it will become bigger also. Because a baby hamster grows. It is a living thing. Is it your pet, Kaylin? It's okay, Kaylin. Okay. Do you understand? Understood. What is the second characteristic of a living thing? Second characteristic, it? Number two, grow. Again, breathe. Number two, grow. Remember that one, ah? Living things, breathe. Living things, grow. Okay? That is number two characteristic. Next one, how do we know if it is a living thing or a non-living thing? What is number three? Page 63. Living things? Hailey, can you read it?
Living things need the food to eat.
Okay, living things need food to eat. Look at this girl. What is she eating?
She's eating vegetables.
How about this rabbits? What are they eating?
Carrots.
Okay, so humans, animals, and plants need food to eat. Why do we eat? Why do you think we eat? Why do you have your breakfast, your lunch, and your dinner? Why?
Yeah.
Why do you eat when you're hungry? Why do you eat?
Because we need energy.
Good. Yes, we need energy. That's why I'm telling you, right? It's important that you eat breakfast because it gives you energy in the morning. If you don't eat, you will be very weak. You will not be able to listen very well in class. If you are very hungry. So you need food. You need to eat to get energy. What else? You need food to
grow.
Oh, you need food to grow. So if you want to grow taller, stronger, and bigger, you need to eat healthy food. You need to eat lots of healthy food in order to stay healthy and to grow. Don't eat a lot of junk food, huh? If you want to grow taller, bigger, and stronger, eat a lot of healthy food. Food that are good for you, like this one. What is the girl eating? She's eating vegetables to make herself healthy and strong. That's why we eat. Animals also eat, see? Because they also need energy and they also need to grow. That's why they eat. How about the plants? Do you know that plants make their own food?
Yeah.
They don't go to the store or they don't cook food, but they make their own food through their leaves. The plants also need to grow, so they make their own food. How about this cell phone? Does this cell phone need to eat? Does the cell phone need to eat food?
Doesn't have mouth.
Doesn't have a mouth, of course, and it also doesn't need to grow like us, like human beings, plants and like animals. So that's the third characteristic of a living thing. A living thing needs food to eat or needs food in order to survive. So we already have three characteristics of living things. Number one, what was it? Number two? Grow.
Living things.
Number three? Need? Living things need?
Need food
to eat. Already three characteristics. Again, breathe, grow, need food to eat. Remember that one. Characteristics of living things. Turn to page 64 now. What else? How can you tell if it is a living thing or a non-living thing?
A living thing.
Third characteristic, living things. Living things. Living things move. Okay, that is the fourth characteristic. Okay, again, I will repeat. Breathe. Grow, need food to eat, and the fourth one, it moves. Living things move. Okay, I'm going to ask, let's see, Rafael, can you read this one?
What will you do when your father throws you a ball? You will try to catch the ball. Living things respond to stimuli
from the table
and move. Very good, Raphael. Thank you, Raphael. So what will you do when your father throws you a ball? You will try to catch the ball. Living things respond to stimuli and move. Stimuli is the plural form of stimulus. When you say stimulus, the things around you. For example, what do you see? What do you hear? What do you smell? What do you taste? What do you touch? Those are stimulus. Okay? Those are stimulus. The things that are around you are stimulus. And respond is? How do you react to it? Your reaction. That is your response. So when you move, that is your response to stimuli. Do you understand what I'm saying? I know it's quite difficult, the term, yeah, but try to understand it. Living things respond to stimulus or stimuli. Okay, meaning react. You react. For example, if you taste something sweet or something good, what do you say? If you eat something delicious, what do you say? If you eat fried chicken, yum. Okay, so fried chicken is the stimulus. And the is your response. How about if you smell something stinky? What do you do? You cover your nose, right? That's your response to something stinky. Oh, that's stimulus. Another one. The father throws you a ball. So the ball... No one is listening to me. Look at me. The ball is the stimulus. When you catch it, that's your response. Okay? Okay? So you react. You react to something when something is happening. So that's what living things do. Living things, we move by ourselves. Okay? We move by ourselves like people. How do you move? Give me an example and how you move.
Touch.
You walk. Very good. What else can you do? What else can you do?
Touching.
Dance.
Dance.
Jump. What else?
Touch.
Dance. You can dance, right?
Yeah.
You can crawl. You can hop. How about animals? What can animals do?
Walk.
Animals can fly. Animals can
run.
What else? Run and walk. Right? So animals are living things. Oh, jump. How about animals move by themselves, right? Human beings, we also move by ourselves. We can move by ourselves.
Yes.
Yes. Plants also move, like the sunflower. But not all plants can move. Some plants can move, like the sunflower. I told you about that one. Yes, you may. About heliotropism. Plants faces the direction of the sun. Oh, that's one way that the plants move. They move, right? They react to stimulus, like the sunflower reacting to the sun. But how about this water bottle? Does this water bottle move by itself?
No.
Does this water bottle move by itself?
No.
No, you need to move it before it moves, right? Because this water bottle is a non-living thing. It does not move by itself. The water bottle only moves if you move it. If you move it, then it moves. But if you don't move it like this, it doesn't move because it is a non-living thing. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
All right. Okay. So that's the fourth characteristic of a living thing. A living thing moves. Okay. Fourth characteristic moves. So, Domenico, can you read this one? A toy car.
A toy car only moves if a person moves it. It does not respond to any stimulus.
Don't do that, Darren.
It is a non-living thing.
Okay, very good. So a toy car only moves if a person moves it. It does not respond to any stimulus. It is a non-living thing. So again, the fourth characteristic of a living thing is it moves. Okay, it moves. So we have number one. What is number one? Living things. Breathe. Number two, living things. Grow. Ay, nobody can remember it. Number three, living things need
food
to eat. Number four, living things. Living things move. Ay, nobody is listening. Again, living things move. Okay, the last one here. Look at this one. A cat is sitting on the table. The cat is a living thing. Why?
Because it moves.
Why is the cat a living thing? There are four reasons why. Why is the cat a living thing?
Four reasons why. It
moves. What else?
And walk.
And run.
And run, yeah, I know it moves. What else?
And walk.
Okay, and jump. And jump. Okay.
Jump.
Yes, very good. Very good. So there are four reasons why this cat is a living thing. Because it moves. What else? It needs food and water to grow. Oh, number two, it grows, right? It grows. Number three, it needs food. It needs food to eat and also water. Remember that one, not only food, but water in order to survive. And number four, the last one is the cat moves. What about the table? Is the table a living thing or a non-living thing?
Non-living.
No.
Non-living thing. Why?
Not move.
They move?
No.
No. They move. Grow? No, it does not grow. Does it breathe?
No.
No, it doesn't breathe. Does it need food and water?
No.
No, it doesn't need food and water. Okay, let's repeat. Repeat again. How do you know if it is alive? Four characteristics. Number one?
Breathe.
Number two? Grow.
Grow.
Grow. Number three? Okay, we will change number three. We will change number three. We will make it complete. Needs food and water, okay? Living things need food and water. Let's change number three, yeah? Make it complete. Okay, number three, living things need?
Food.
Food and?
Water.
Water. Number four, the last one, living things?
Move.
Very good. Let's repeat again. Number one, living things.
Breathe.
Number two, living things.
And
grow.
Number three, living things need.
Food and water.
Food and water. And the last one, living things.
Can move.
Move. Very good. Okay. Let's see. Show me an example of a living thing. Go. Show me an example of a living thing.
It moves.
Human.
Yourself.
Human.
Show me yourself.
Human.
Show me yourself. Show me yourself in the camera. Show yourself because you're a living thing. Are you a living thing? If you are not a living thing, you don't show yourself in the camera. You hide. Are you a living thing? Show yourself in the camera. Now show me a non-living thing. Go. Non-living thing. Non-living. Very good. Okay, show me another example of a non-living. Non-living. Okay, very good. Do you have your sister or your brother there, or your mom or your dad or your mom? Yeah. Show me living thing. Another example of living thing.
I don't have here.
Show me. You don't have anyone there with you. Show me another living thing. Sister.
Yeah, what is?
Or mommy, or daddy, or nanny, or baby brother, baby sister.
My sister.
Okay. Hi. All right. Okay.
Yeah, human being kan?
Okay, good job guys. Okay, let's answer now. Let's try to answer page 66. Page 66. Turn to page 66.
Done.
Let's answer page 66.
I guess living or non-living.
Let's read the instruction first. Living or non-living? Look at the pictures. How do we know if something is alive or has never been alive? We already discussed the four reasons why, right? What are the four reasons why? Just tell me, no need to write it down. What are the four reasons why? If it is alive, it
grows.
Number two?
Breathe.
Number one is breathe. Number two, grow. Number three, needs food and water. And number four, it moves.
It
moves. Very good. Okay, now you do this one. Draw a circle around things that are alive. So you circle now. Which one? Is it this tree, the fish, the horse, the rock, and the toy? Circle now. Which one are living things? Which are alive?
Horse, fish, tree.
Very good. Okay. Are your answers also tree, fish, horse?
Horse.
Who got the correct answer? Raise your hand. Good job. Pat yourself. Pat yourself. And say, I'm awesome. I'm awesome. Okay, next one. You circle. Let's read the instruction. Which words describe living things? Which one describes living things? Draw a circle around them. So this one is already done for you. Walk. Walk a circle because animals move, right? How about water? Does water describe living things? Is water a living thing? Yes or no? No. Water is not a living thing.
What page? Miss, what page?
We're already on page 66, Haley. Page 66. Okay, right, Haley is not following us. How about it? Does it describe a living thing? Do living things eat? Yes or no? Hello?
Yes.
Yes, circle it now.
I already done that. Move, breathe.
Very good. How about table?
Tiger.
Is table tiger a living thing?
Tiger living
no
thing. No. How about move? Do living things move?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, very good. How about breathe?
Do I'm done.
Breathe.
Miss, I'm done.
Very good, Raphael. Do living things breathe?
Miss, I'm done.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. How about chair? Is chair a living thing?
No.
No. How about grow? Do living things grow?
Yeah.
Yes.
How about plastic? Is plastic a living thing?
No.
No. How about wood? Is wood a living thing?
No.
No.
No. Wood is not a living thing, ah. I will tell you the difference why. Okay.
Tiger.
This is wood. Wood is already cut, right? Oh, it's already cut. It's not alive anymore, so it's not a living thing. But if it is a tree is a living thing because it's still alive. That's the difference, ah. Because wood comes from trees, wood is not a living thing, but a tree is a living thing. Okay? Did you get it? Understood? How about stone? Is stone a living thing?
No.
How about a tiger?
Yes.
Yes. How about glass?
No.
Oh, okay, that's it. The last one, last question. Is a dead plant alive? Is a dead plant alive? No, it's already dead. Again, again, a living thing is something that breathes, that grows, that needs food and water. And the last one is that it moves. Oh, it's dead already, so it's not alive. Any questions about living things?
No.
One? No. Let's repeat. Four characteristics of living things. Tell me. Number one, what is it? Living things?
Breathe.
Number two.
Need.
Grow.
Number three.
Need food and water.
Needs food and water. Now, and the last one. Living things? Very good. Okay, get your workbook now. Get your workbook. Did you get your workbook already? Open it to page Page 23. Page 23. Okay, later you submit your work later, ha? You color the living things. Okay, exercise one, number one. Any color you want. But make sure you use the correct color, okay? Like for example, a rose.
I know.
Make sure that
rose
you color
a
rose color. Okay, now. Color the living things. Remember, living things are human beings, plants, and animals. Page 23. 23, Jonathan. Page 23. Any color you want, okay? I will remind you, living things are plants, animals, and humans, human beings. Color the living things.
Rose, living thing or not?
Rose is a living thing because it's a plant.
A hippo is a living thing. A hippo is a living thing.
It's not a hippo. That's a rhinoceros.
Rhinoceros.
Hippo. 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 Soccer ball and bike. Bicycle.
All of them.
Are you going to color all of them, Haley? No. Only the living things, okay. Haley. Only the living things. Living things are animals, yes. Plants, and human beings. Yes? Page 23.
I cannot find my color pencil.
How come? Crayon. Do you have a crayon?
I have crayon.
Use crayon. And then this one, I will read the instruction you do by yourself. You circle if it's true or false. True is correct. False is wrong. Huh? You choose which one, true or false. For example, this one.
What page?
Oh, 23. 2, 3. All things around us are living or non-living. Yes, what is it? All things around us are living or non-living. True or false? True! I told you before, right? Everything that exists in the world can be divided into two groups, living or non-living things. Huh? Everything that exists in our world can be divided into living or non-living things. Or, because it says here, or non-living things, right? Now you answer the rest, huh? Choose which one, true or false. All things around us are non-living only. True or false? Only non-living.
False.
Yes, don't say the answer. A banana tree is a living thing. Tree, see? Tree. Told you a tree is?
True.
Yeah, don't say the answer. Next, a swing and a seesaw are non-living things, true or false? You know what is a swing, right?
Uh-oh. Yes.
You play in the, with the swing in the playground and the seesaw. Circle your answer. And the last one, the last page that you are going to answer, this one. You tick for yes and X for no. Cross it out for no. Like this, I'll help you with number one. A chicken or a hen. Does it breathe? Of course. Does it eat? Yes. Does it grow? Yes. Does it move? Yes. Is it living? Yes. How about the book? The book, does it breathe? No. Does it eat? No. Does it grow? No. Does it move? No. Move by itself, yeah? No. Is it living? No. Like that, yeah? Answer by yourself. You answer the rest. The boy and the stuffed teddy bear. That's a stuffed toy. Okay, that's it. Then later you send your work into, submit your work in Teams.
Yep.
I'll create first in team.
That means
done. Okay, wait. Yeah, I'll make first in the team so you can submit your work. Science workbook. Pages 23 to 24. Science workbook pages 23 to 24. Okay, submit it in the team. Okay, take a picture, then submit it in the team.
Means until page what?
24 only. Page 24 only. Okay. Done? And 23 and 24 only. Finish. Can take a picture and then submit it in the science team. You are finished.
Yes. In assignment.
Yes.
Yes, in the assignment in Teams. Pages 23. Yes, Dominica.
My mom and my dad are working.
Yeah, later. You can send it later, okay? Send it later.
Last time, my mom just teach me how to submit. And then I just did it and then I just...
So you can already... it's okay. You can practice next time. Taking a picture, then submitting.
I don't know how to submit.
Just take picture and then submit. Okay, one more minute, yeah, and then we're going to pray. It's already time.
Robot.
Do this. Then
put up kadang.
Yeah, the environment don't answer yet, yeah. Stand. Don't answer that one yet. Only until page 24. We haven't discussed yet in the environment. Okay, so let's pray now. It's already 1 o'clock. Okay, let's pray, guys. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you for this day. Thank you for everything you have done for us. Please be with us always today, Lord. Cover us with your precious blood. Guide us and protect us always. Keep us safe and healthy. In Jesus' name, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Okay, goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye, Miss.
Goodbye,
Bye. Don't forget to send your work. Submit your work. Bye. Bye. I'll end the meeting now. Bye.